don't wanna go there. We should never go there. Why you wanna go there? I guess I gotta go there.
Good evening, podcast listeners. This is Marcus Norman coming to you live with another episode of Gentleman Style Podcast. Tonight's episode is going to be brief, but still, I hope it's still full of information and wisdom and encouraging to all the men out there. I hope this episode, as you may have read in the title, I hope it strikes a nerve and it really tunes you in, because all my podcasts, I hope to encourage you, uplift you, and provide insight. But this story, I wanted to share this story to you because it was very unique to me, and a wise woman shared it with me, and so I wanted to share it with you because it opened my mind to something that I think most men don't think about and oftentimes forget. So I'm not going to leave you guessing any longer. I want you to tune in and listen in, and I want you to hear this. And then afterwards, we'll go in and dive in a little bit on what this story means to me. So listen up, tune in, check it out.
Once upon a time, there was a king with four wives. One day, the king got sick. Was on his deathbed. Afraid of being in the afterlife alone, he asked his fourth wife, which he loved the most, and bought her diamonds and gold, and he asked her, "Would you die with me and go with me to the afterlife?" The fourth wife replied, "I'm sorry, I can't do that," and walked away. He also loved his third wife and was very proud and would always show her off to neighboring kingdoms. So he called on his third wife and asked, "Would you accompany me to the afterlife?" The third wife replied, "I love my life too much, and I'm sorry I cannot go with you. And when you die, I'm going to remarry." His second wife has always been there for him in his times of need. So he asked, "Would you accompany me to the afterlife?" The second wife then replied, "I'm sorry that I can't help you out this time, but what I can do is arrange your funeral, and I will be there for your funeral." A voice called out and said, "I'll leave with you and follow you wherever you go, even if it is to the afterlife." And the king looked, and it was his first wife. But this was the wife that he took care of the least. He felt embarrassed and said, "I'm sorry, I should have taken more care of you, given you more attention when I was alive." The moral of this story is that we all have four wives. Our fourth wife is our body. We like to decorate it with nice jewelry, nice clothing, but in the end, it can't follow us to the afterlife. The third wife represents our possessions. We spend so much time trying to gather possessions, but in the end, they cannot follow us to the afterlife. It will be given to other people and divided. Just like the third wife said, she's going to remarry. The second wife, our friends and family. We trust them. They're always there for us in times of need. But the furthest they can go with us is to our funeral and send us off. Our first wife. The first wife represents our soul. We usually neglect taking care of our soul. That is the thing that will follow us to the afterlife. Care for your body. Keep it healthy. Enjoy your possessions and the comfort they provide. Cherish your friends and family for the love that they provide. But don't forget to take care of your soul. Nourish your soul. Take time to be alone. Take time to pray. Take time to meditate, because it is the source of all of your life and your most faithful friend. I hope this story can help you or somebody that you love. My name is Sean Rudanakiran. Sawasdee krap.
All right, gentlemen. So as you've guessed it, that he pretty much summed up the message that I wanted to deliver to you all tonight. This added tremendous value to me. For a long time, I was focusing on the wrong things, and I wasn't focusing on the things that were important to me. And I've let my health, my mind, my body, my heart deteriorate over time. And so, if anything else, I wanted to inspire and encourage the young men out there to feel empowered, and to take ownership of your life and make it the best life that you can possible, and be sure to take time in the things that are important to you and that matter to you, and take care of your body, your enjoy your possessions, and make sure you take care of your spirit above all else via meditation, extreme focus, and quality time with yourself, and use that time to really become self-aware of who you are and where you are and where you want to go. And it's only through that time of self-reflection that you'll truly find yourself and find out what's important to you. So, man, like I said, it was a quick episode. I wanted to inspire you, as all my episodes, I want them to be encouraging and uplifting to you, but also to remind you to take time out and do some self-reflection so that your future is more guided, and your future steps that you take are more focused because you took the time out to get to know yourself and get to know the direction you're heading in and what it is you truly desire and your passions and your what you enjoy and what you love. So men, stay encouraged like always, and always, gentlemen, take care of your family, take care of your friends, and take care of business. This is Marcus Norman, Gentleman Style Podcast, signing off. Have a good night. Bye.
I don't want to go there. We should never go there. Why you wanna go there? I guess I gotta go there.